Te Ao Māori is in mourning today for one of its unsung heroes. The Ngāti Hine elder, Pita Paraone, died early this morning in Auckland Hospital. The 73-year-old served for many years as a public servant and New Zealand First politician. But as our Northland reporter Lois Williams reports, he will also be remembered as the man who saved Waitangi.
Pita Paraone, who helped organise this year's festivities, joins us now from the treaty grounds. Kia ora, good morning.
Kia ora from Waitangi.
The familiar voice of Pita Paraone, called on after every Waitangi Day for years to explain to listeners what went wrong and what went right. As chair of the Waitangi National Trust and organiser of the official programme, he was perennially frustrated by what he called the shenanigans at Te Ti Marae, but he was eternally optimistic that all could be resolved. 2 years ago, Mr Paraone lost patience and took charge, transforming the dreaded Crown Pōwhiri from chaos to spectacular pageant. New Zealand First's Shane Jones explains.
I recall him inviting Kingi Taurua to a hapū meeting and informing Kingi Taurua that in future there would be no more fireworks down at the lower Waitangi Marae. Events were going to be moved to the top marae so that the dignity and the mana associated with Waitangi was restored. Not an easy thing to do, say, indeed to execute, but through his role at Waitangi and obviously his own lineage in Ngāti Hine, he was able to deliver on that outcome.
At the time, Mr Paraone said protests had been legitimate at Waitangi since 1840, but he was no longer prepared to have Ngāpuhi held up to ridicule.
The ceremonies are one of welcome, and then some of the protests that's occurred certainly isn't in keeping with what one would expect from a civilised nation.
Pita Paraone was a direct descendant of the great Ngāti Hine fighting chief turned peacemaker, Kawiti. But he also honoured his Pākehā forebears and celebrated the bicultural ideal, and he walked and talked easily in both worlds. He entered politics in 2002 as a New Zealand First List MP, and he served three terms, losing his seat at the last election. But well before that, he'd had leading roles in Māori affairs, Te Puni Kōkiri, the Māori Trustee, and the Māori Language Commission, Te Tauta Whiri, and more recently as chair of the Local Government Commission. He was made a member of the New Zealand Order of Merit in 1997 for his services to Māori and the community. And his death has drawn tributes from MPs on all sides of the House, including the Prime Minister, Jacinda Ardern.
And of course I've had a bit to do with him as well while he was involved with the Waitangi commemorations and the Waitangi National Trust. And I found him to be thoughtful, considered, a kind man. And I know he'll be a real loss to the North in particular.
Pita Paraone's cousin, Peter Tipene, says the Ngāti Hine elder was a quiet, courteous achiever who never liked to fuss, and his death has come as a shock to many who didn't know he was unwell.
Like the person that he is, he said, please don't share this with anyone. Pita, I'm going into hospital, I'm going in for heart surgery, it's quite serious. And please don't share anything with anyone, I want to really keep this low key, so I didn't. But it's slowly been coming out over the last 3 weeks that he was in a bad way.
Pita Paraone's whānau expect to take him back from Auckland to his home marae of Mōtātau in the Bay of Islands tomorrow.
E karai pita ko rewa te waka. Tēnei mātou ki uto I a koe ki rungi te waka. Te hoki ai koe ki o tūpuna ki o mātua. E moi, moi o tiatue.
And that is Shane Jones ending that story from Lois Williams.